In this video, we will illustrate some fundamental concepts on spectrum analyzers by doing basic measurements with a high-end instrument. This is the front panel of the Keysight MXA N9020B signal analyzer. There are several models currently available covering different frequency bandwidths. This one can measure from 10 Hz to 26.5 GHz. The control can be made by either hardware or software keys, and the screen has nice multi-touch capabilities. But here we will control the analyzer with a mouse in order to facilitate the visualization of the screen. Along the top of the display are tabs, one for each measurement screen you have defined. We can tap the plus sign to clone the current measurement, which can be changed afterwards for a new configuration, in a way that is very similar to an internet navigator. You can have up to 16 measurement tabs, but only 6 can be viewed at one time. Right below the screen tabs area, one finds the measurement bar. This shows general measurement settings and information. The annotations on this bar can be used to change configuration settings. We can tap anywhere in the annotation box to access a drop-down panel that contains relevant parameters. The bottom bar contains several icons like the Windows key, undo or redo, a Windows File Explorer, help, and some view options. At the right part of the screen, one finds the menu panel. In this panel, you can tap the system configuration icon to access different system settings like instrument diagnostics, user interface options, sound settings, Windows controls, and others. The preset icon gives you access to the utilities to return the instrument to a non-predefined state. The main area of the menu panel is reserved for a drop-down menu that contains the basic configuration options of any spectrum analyzer. In addition, one can access the same options via the block diagram icon. Let us see how it works. In the default configuration, the instrument shows you a full span measurement with both a resolution and video bandwidths equal to 3 MHz. If we tap on the drop-down menu, we see the options to set amplitude scale, resolution bandwidth, display, frequency scale, and some others. Now, if I tap on the block diagram icon, we can access the options of the menu panel and measurement bar in a more intuitive way. Here you can identify easily how are the main building blocks of the analyzer. We can come back to the previous menu by tapping on the block diagram option again. The measurement bar is interesting. Let us check some options to improve the detection of weak signals. Let us reduce the input attenuation from 10 to 0 dBs, and this allows me to increase the sensitivity of the instrument in a similar factor. We can further improve this with the aid of internal preamplifiers. Let us activate the preamplifier for the lowest frequency band, and we see that the sensitivity increases in more than 10 dBs up to a frequency of 3.6 GHz. But the most significant improvements in the sensitivity are achieved by reducing the resolution bandwidth. Let us check this. We go to Frequency menu and choose a center frequency of 2 GHz and a span of 1 kHz. Doing this, both bandwidths are automatically reduced and the noise floor level drops well below -130 dBm. This level is usually called displayed average noise level. The improvement we obtained is actually due to the automatic reduction of the resolution bandwidth. It was 3 MHz before, now it is only 9.1 Hz. Let us see how much is the noise level now. We go to the amplitude menu and reduce the reference level to -100 dBm. Doing this, I actually can see that the noise level is now around -160 dBm. But now we can observe a weak peak with a power below -130 dBm at the center frequency. This is actually an artifact of the measurement. Sometimes one observes artifacts in the spectral displays that are the result of limitations of mixer and filter circuits, or even numerical limitations in the calculation of the Fourier transform. This happens if one works with very weak signals or tries to display a spectra at frequencies beyond the nominal bandwidth of the instrument. Let us see the influence of the resolution bandwidth on the sweep time and noise. The analyzer displays the sweep time at the bottom of the screen. It is now 1 millisecond and the average noise level is around -130 dBm. Now I reduce the resolution bandwidth to 100 Hz and the analyzer automatically increases the sweep time to 2 seconds, but at the same time we could reduce the noise level in around 20 dBs. Let's come back to the resolution bandwidth of 9.1 kHz and reduce the video bandwidth instead. Let us specify a video bandwidth of 100 Hz. And we see that the sweep time has also increased significantly as compared to the original configuration. This time is more than 800 milliseconds. Observe that now we have smoothed the trace, facilitating the detection of weak peaks above the noise, but the noise level itself is not changed. It is again -130 dBm. Let us do another test. Now we reduce the video bandwidth to 1 Hz. This is quite interesting. Let us check some numbers. Here we see another measurement where the video bandwidth is also set to only 1 Hz. This enables us to estimate accurately the displayed average noise level. It is around -108 dBm for a resolution bandwidth of 1 MHz. If we reduce the resolution bandwidth in a factor of 10, the displayed average noise level drops to -119 dBm. And if we reduce the resolution bandwidth again, and in the same factor, the noise level drops 10 dBs more. We can also check what happens with the sweep time for the same changes in the resolution bandwidth. We started having a sweep time of 2.11 seconds. Then it raised to 21.1 seconds. And finally we got 211 seconds. We can observe that this dependence of the sweep time with the resolution bandwidth doesn't fit to the one we obtained in our previous video by making the assumption that the IF filters were analog. Therefore, it seems that in these measurements the analyzer uses some improved techniques to speed up the measurement, probably digital filters and maybe some refinements to correct distortions due to high-speed sweeps. In any case, we might need to improve the speed even more. Let us see how. The analyzer has two different modes to sweep the spectrum of a signal. These are the classical swept spectrum mode, based on sweeping the local oscillator, and the fast Fourier transform mode, based on the numerical calculation of the spectrum from the data digitized in the time domain. This second mode is actually equivalent to the FFT functions one typically finds in the oscilloscopes. Depending on your needs, you may prefer one mode or another. If dynamic range and amplitude resolution are important to your measurement, you will probably use the swept mode. But if you need faster sweep speeds at narrow bandwidths, the FFT mode will be your best option. To select the sweep mode, we must tap on Sweep option, then go to Sweep configuration and tap Sweep type. Now we choose FFT and observe that the measurement speed noticeably increases. The analyzer also displays the sweep time in the FFT mode, but the error in this estimation can be quite large, up to 40% according to the instrument specifications. Anyway, both modes offer us a wide range of options to optimize the measurement of a signal spectrum. But let us assume now that we want to track the spectrum of a signal that is constantly changing with time. The real-time spectrum analyzer has emerged in recent years to cover the needs of characterizing non-stationary signals. It happens that the instrument we have used here is also a real-time spectrum analyzer. If you are interested in this topic, don't miss our next video.